Hi there, Serdar Yagulab here for InfoWorld at IDG. Welcome to the first installment of a new video series, Smart Go. In this series, we'll be exploring the Go programming language originally created by folks at Google and now an important and thriving part of the modern IT landscape. Many high-profile projects like Docker and Kubernetes are built with Go. Go was originally created in 2009 and is built as a language that makes it easy to build simple, reliable, and efficient software. The simple part refers chiefly to Go's syntax and concepts. Reliable means Go apps don't require you to manage memory manually, eliminating a whole class of programming errors. And efficient means you can readily create programs that make the most of multi-core machines or use concurrency to deal with multiple I/O streams. To give you a simple idea of what it's like to work with Go, here's a very tiny Go program which I've written in Visual Studio Code using the Go add-ons available for it. If you're familiar with C or Java, much of Go's syntax should also be familiar, like the use of curly braces to offset blocks of code, or the use of main as a common entry point into a program. Variables and function signatures are all typed, as they would be in C and Java, although for this example we're only using int as our type. To work with a Go program we've written, we use the Go command line tool simply called Go. This tool gives us a central point to handle management and packaging of Go apps. For instance, to run this program in place, we just use go run and the file name. This compiles the program into an executable and runs it, although the executable doesn't appear in our program directory. Note that the compilation cycle is quite fast. This is something Go prides itself on. Working with Go is meant to have a development cycle closer to that of an interpreted language like Python than, say, C++, where compilation times can become quite long. We'll be able to see better examples of how Go compiles quickly with a much larger program in the future. If we want to compile a Go program into a standalone redistributable executable, we can do that with the go build command. The resulting executable has no dependencies. It can be a little bit on the big side for starters, though, because it's statically linked by default. For instance, this simple little program here will weigh in at about 1 megabyte. But there are ways to slim it down, such as removing the debugging information. And this is something we will explore in greater detail in future videos. In the next videos, I'll be diving a little deeper into how Go programs are put together. So for now, take care. If you like this video, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to the IDG Tech Talk channel on YouTube. And for more Smart Go and Smart Python tips, be sure to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.